Hi guys! Welcome back to my channel. In this video, ituturo ko kung ano nga ba ang ibig sabihin ng isang normal curve. So, the normal distribution or simply as normal curve is a bell-shaped distribution which has important role in inferential statistics. It provides a graphical representation of statistical values that are needed in describing the characteristics of population as well as in making decision. This graph, guys, is an example of a normal curve. So, ano bang ibig sabihin yan? So, let's say kinuha natin yung test score results nyo sa isang subject. Okay? So, alam naman natin, sa mga lowest, sa lowest scores ng ating data at saka sa highest scores, is konti lang yung students na nandito. Okay? So, siguro sa lowest score, siguro isa lang or dalawa. Tama? Then, sa highest scores naman, so syempre, let's say, may mga naka-perfect. So, hindi naman ganun karami yung mga nakaka-perfect during exams. Tama? Then, commonly, habang pumupunta tayo doon sa scores na nasa bandang gitna, let's say kung 1 to 50 yan, ito yung mga scores na nasa around 20 to 30, doon na pupunta or doon na nagtitipon-tipon yung mga scores ng mga students. Okay? So, kung papansin ninyo guys, yung trend ng graph na to is commonly, majority ng students is nasa gitna. Okay? Then, kung i-check niyo yung trend ng ating histogram, it follows the normal distribution. Okay? So, yan yung tinatawag natin guys na normal distribution. Okay? So, the normal distribution refers to a continuous probability distribution described by this normal equation. So, a random variable x whose distribution has the shape of a normal curve called a normal random variable. So, this random variable x is said to be normally distributed with mean and standard deviation. So, mamaya, ipapaliwanag ko ano ba yung role ng mean and standard deviation sa ating normal curve. Okay? So, next, let's have the properties of normal distribution. Number one, the distribution curve is a bell shape. So, kita naman natin, guys, na yung curve natin is a bell shape. So, number two, the curve is symmetrical about its center. So, kung kukunin natin, guys, yung center ng ating normal curve, which is nandito, pag sinabi natin symmetrical, para siyang mirror. Okay? So, kung ano yung nasa left side natin, ganun din yung nasa right side. Okay? Then, number three, the mean, median, and mode coincide at the center. So, pagka pinahanap sa inyo si mean, median, and mode, so dito natin sila makikita sa center. Nakuha ba guys? So, the tails of the curve flatten out indefinitely along the horizontal axis, always approaching the axis but never touching it. So, kung mapansin nyo, pagka nag-drawing tayo guys ng normal curve, dapat hindi nakadikit yung normal curve natin doon sa ating horizontal line. So, that is the curve is asymptomatic to the baseline. Then, last property natin guys, number 5, the total area under the normal curve is equal to 1. Or 100%. So, tandaan tong area na to guys. Kasi magagamit natin to dun sa ating next lesson. Okay? So, kung ang total area ng ating normal curve is 100% or 1, meaning, yung nasa left side ng ating center is equivalent to 0.50, then yung nasa right side natin is 0.50 rin. Or pareha silang tag 50%. Okay, so tandaan niyo, again, tandaan natin itong property nito kasi useful to dun sa ating next topic. Okay? So, we have two factors that the graph of the normal distribution may depend on. So, una is yung ating mean. It determines the location of the center of the bell-shaped curve. Thus, a change in the value of the mean shifts the graph of the normal curve to the right or to the left. Meaning guys, kung ang mean natin is masyadong mababa, no? So, or nag-ipon-ipon yung ating scores dun sa pinaka-lowest value. So, yung curve natin maaaring hindi maging bell-shaped. So, maaaring maging ganito yung curve natin, guys, no? Parang ganyan. Okay? So, nandito, nagtipon-tipon yung mga scores dito sa medyo mababang value. And kung masyado namang nasa may highest value yung ating mean, so, maaaring maging ganito naman yung itsura ng ating curve. Masyadong mataas na sa may bandang dulo. Okay? So, hindi siya magiging bell shape. Then, number two na nakaka-apekto sa ating normal curve is yung standard deviation. It determines the shape of the graphs, particularly yung height and width. So, let's say meron tayong large value of standard deviation. So, it makes the normal curve short and wide. So, since malaki yung standard deviation, meaning yung mga numbers natin or yung mga data natin is magkakalayo. So, kung magkakalayo, masyadong magiging wide yung ating normal curve. So, ang epekto nito is parang lumiit yung ating bell shape. Okay? Lumiit yung ating normal curve. So, what if naman kung ang standard deviation natin is masyado namang maliit? Small value of standard deviation yields a skinnier and taller normal curve. Kung masyado namang dikit-dikit yung ating scores dun sa mean, okay? So, ang mangyayari is masyadong payat yung ating normal curve, then at the same time, mataas yung peak. Nakuha ba, guys? So, again, yung dalawang nakaka-apekto sa itsura ng ating normal distribution or normal curve is yung mean and standard deviation. Next is we have the standard normal curve. So, it is a normal probability distribution that has a mean equal to 0 and the standard deviation is equal to 1. So, in next topic natin, guys, ituturo ko kung paano ba mag-convert ng normal curve to standard normal curve. Okay? Or yung mga data natin or yung mga scores natin, i-convert natin to standard scores. So, ngayon, ano bang ibig sabihin ng 0 dito? Yung 0 dito sa ating normal curve, it represents the mean. Okay? Then yung 1, 2, 3, tsaka negative 1, negative 2, negative 3 natin, yan yung ating distance kung ilang standard deviation away tayo from the mean. Okay? So, every normal curve, regardless of its mean or standard deviation, conforms to the following empirical rule. So, itong empirical rule na ito, guys, is sometimes called 68-95-99.7. So, ano bang ibig sabihin nito, guys? So, dito, guys, about 68.26% of the area under the normal curve falls within the one standard deviation from the mean. Okay? So, yun yung ibig sabihin ng 68 dun sa ating empirical rule. And 95.44% of the area under the normal curve falls within the two standard deviations away from the mean. Nakuha, guys? Then about 99.73% ng ating area under the normal curve falls within the three standard deviations from the mean. So, yan yung ibig sabihin ng ating empirical rule. So, gagamitin natin tong idea na to sa susunod nating topic. Okay, guys? So, this is the end of our video. I hope may natutunan kayo. So, if you have questions or clarifications, kindly put them in the comment section below. So, thank you guys for watching. This is Prof. D. I'll catch you on the flip side. Bye!